She's originally from Inglewood, and she still lives there. Give it up for Felicia, folks!
Oh, man. Thank you. No one's taking shots in the hallway, so this may be a drier set than I'm used to, so here we go. Guys, I'm so happy to be here. I used to be a bank teller, so I am a survivor. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I can't fight any of you right now. I don't know. I didn't like being a bank teller. I learned two things about myself on that bank telling journey that I was not ready for. One, I learned that men are the most confident things alive. Do you understand what I'm telling you? They're the most confident. It's too much. I don't understand it. I would get hit on every day at the bank, every day, by a man with negative money in his account. Do you understand? Negative money. Below the zero. Do you know what I mean? And I'd go on the date because he was confident. You get what I'm saying? Like, maybe he has a second account. I don't know. I'm just... He never had a second account. Paid for a lot of two dates. Okay. I don't know. I learned the bank was racist. That's another very important thing I learned. The most racist place I ever worked was the bank. Mostly because I worked in the hood. I am from Inglewood, born and raised. Thank you so much. What an honor and a privilege. And no one else from Inglewood, please clap. Thank you. And it's just like, I used to work in Inglewood and we had like a protocol. And then one day I got transferred out to like Beverly Hills. And I walked into that bank and there was no bulletproof glass. Do you get what I'm saying? Like, Beverly Hills banks have no bulletproof glass sometimes. They just go in there, it's like, oh yeah, you can just go in here. We don't think nobody gonna steal. Like, they just do that. Every bank in Inglewood has bars and shit. Do you get what I'm saying? Like, we have security, we have, there's no, okay, y'all got money. Okay, this is a money crowd at the Dynamics. That's something I need to know. That's something I need to know. It was just crazy. Like, one day, I walked in, and I was like, we're not going to work. And she's like, no, we're going to work at this bank. And I was like, fine, let's work. And this old white lady, after breathing in my mouth multiple times, she asked me for candy to suck on and, like, fruit water and shit at the Beverly Hills Bank. And I was like, bitch, we ain't got shit for you. You know what I mean? I just did my training that I learned. I was like, bitch, we ain't got shit for you. And my manager ran up. He was like, no, we have stuff for her. We have food for her. It's on that table. The candy's on that table. And I was like, over there? She was like, yeah. I was like, I thought some old bitch just like emptied her purse out and I was gonna clean it up. You know what I mean? That's for the customers? She was like, yeah, that's for the customers. And I was like, okay, fine. I don't know what this shit is. At the Inglewood Bank, we don't have your fucking money. Do you get what I'm saying? You come in there and you just gotta leave. You stand in line for an hour and I'm like, you gotta go home. My window closed. I'm having fun. I just had to check. Okay. I was like, no, it's good. It's fine. I am from Inglewood. It's getting gentrified. What a dream, what a nightmare, what a dream, what a nightmare. Things are on time and a little cleaner, but I can't stand the neighbors. I can't stand them. I don't have, people think it's like a racial thing. I don't have a problem with my neighbors. The issue is, it's a cultural thing. They're not getting the culture. Like, I have this beautiful new white couple on my street, you know? I'm very happy. They have a beautiful son. His name is Hunter. I call him little nigga. They don't like that. But he's new to the street. I'm trying to make him comfortable. You know what I mean? I like him. They don't like the culture because, like, a car on the street got broken into. It is a problem, you know? We all wanted to talk about it on the street. They wanted to have like a group meeting and they were like, we need security. We need security on this street and you don't want to cause no problems. So we're like, okay, what do you want to have security, guys? How do we make you guys feel okay so you don't do something crazy? And they were just like, we want security. We want it to be like, I don't know, like an off-duty cop and I want him driving up and down the street all night watching everybody. And I was like, okay, this is where the culture clashes because we have a different idea of security, okay? Because when you said security, I was thinking like my mom and aunt on each corner with like a belt and a shoe, you know? Like true security. They raised half the people on this block. Maybe little nigga did it. Maybe he's the newest person here. We don't know him. I don't know. I have three white friends. Yes, I count them. They count me. I think fair is fair. Stop it. Stop it. I do. My three white friends are very worried about racism. They're very sweet girls, but they're very worried about racism right now. They think like they're always gonna do something racist, and I have to like tell them it's okay. Like, you know, not everything, I mean, some things you do, but not everything you do is racist. And they're like, oh no, it's always something. But I always have to make them comfortable. Like, we were in Vegas and it was nighttime and they started taking pictures, okay? As a group, we all started taking pictures. Now, I don't know if you guys know how like night works and melanin works, okay? But night's dark and I'm dark. That's science. That's science, okay? So we all start taking pictures and none of them are turning the flash on. You get what I'm saying? They're just taking pictures at night with me, none of them, no flash. And I'm like, y'all gonna turn that flash on? And they're like, oh my God, Felicia, we can't just flash you like that. That's racist and hurtful. We can't just flash you like that. And I'm like, it's way more racist and hurtful just post these pictures on Facebook the next day. Like, I didn't go to Vegas with you bitches. You know what I mean? Don't do that. Turn the flash on. And even if you can't see me, don't tag me in the night sky. Why do they keep doing that? Why? You know I'm not up there. I was standing next to you. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. There's a lot of like black women support happening right now, which is stressing me out. I'm an introvert. I don't really like any contact, and it's coming at me aggressively. Like, a lot of white people are aggressively like loving black people. It's like, please, I don't know you. Please back up. You running at me. I don't like it. Like, I was standing outside with my friend out of comedy club, and we both have natural hair, so we were kind of asking for it. But these two girls saw us, these two white girls saw us, and they were just like, Queens! Queen, you two, Queen, slay! Yes, Queen, slay! Yes, twerk, get them! Queen! 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 Imagine, I was gonna step on this table, but then I was like, this is a taping. I'll do it for the taping. Fuck, Queen! Okay, that doesn't have the strength. That wasn't in the budget. I told them to get it in the budget, strong table in the front. It was a $22 table. Y'all couldn't get the match. No. They were just yelling shit. I don't like it. I don't like when people are just like, Queen, slay. Yes, it's like, Queen. Can a bitch just be an office manager? You know what I mean? Nobody wants you to be an office manager. I do great clerical work. I have an AA degree for that. But you want me to slay. How do you slay? Do we need a sword? Do you need a sword? Do I need a spell book? I'm not supposed to look in that camera, but it's moving. You know what I mean? It's the moving one. I don't know. Sorry, guys. I lost a lot of weight recently, and I'm carb deprived, and I can't fucking think. People want you to be happy when you lose a lot of weight, but I'm not. I'm just, where's the bread? You smell it? Somebody got it. I can smell it in somebody's pocket. I don't like it. I'm a third wheel a lot, which is why I can't make a lot of eye contact in this room right now. I am a third wheel a lot. I like being a third wheel. You're not supposed to like being a third wheel. You're supposed to hate it. That's fucking bullshit. That's fucking fake news. That's the real fake news. You know what I mean? I love being a third wheel. Imagine, your friends could be fucking at any time and they're hanging out with you. What an honor. You ungrateful. Like, I don't feel supportive in my friendships until my friends are making love and they stop and they look each other in the eyes and they're like, I wish Felicia was here. And I'm like, yes! And I'm there watching, because I'm a good friend. Towels, juice. The whole thing. Guys, bye.
Felicia, folks! Our show, please.